Earth is the densest planet in our solar system, while Saturn is the least dense. In fact, Saturn's density is so low that it could float if there were a bathtub large enough to hold it. This low density is typical for gas giants like Saturn. However, astronomers have discovered planets orbiting other stars with even lower densities. These planets are so light and fluffy that they belong to a category of their own, often called superpuffs, puffball, or cotton candy planets. These worlds are as intriguing as their names suggest. Though puffball planets can be similar in size to gas giants like Jupiter or Saturn, their masses are much smaller than expected, giving them an airy, puffed-up appearance. This suggests that these planets are composed mostly of gas, with perhaps a small rocky core, and are surrounded by a very thick atmosphere. Today we will explore some of the most extreme examples of puffball planets, and how some of them might have even fooled astronomers. Kepler-51 system, located about 2,600 light-years from Earth in the constellation Cygnus, is famous for having some of the puffiest planets ever discovered, with densities lower than that of cotton candy. Their radii are similar to Jupiter's, but their masses are only a few times that of Earth. For instance, Kepler-51b has an estimated density of just 0.03 grams per cubic centimeter, making it around 100 times less dense than Earth. Their unusual puffiness likely results from extremely thick atmospheres composed mostly of hydrogen and helium. All three planets have relatively short orbital periods. Kepler-51b, for example, orbits its star in just about 45 days, while C and D take approximately 85 and 130 days, respectively. These short periods mean the planets are relatively close to their host star, which likely contributes to their atmospheric expansion due to stellar radiation. The star around which these planets orbit, Kepler-51, is relatively young, only about 500 million years old, which helps explain the planet's unusual characteristics. Young stars often host planets with bloated atmospheres, which may shrink over time. It's possible that as the system matures, these puffball planets could lose some of their atmosphere and become denser. Another puffball planet is WASP-107b, which orbits a K-type main sequence star about 200 light-years away in the Virgo constellation. The planet's mass is about 1/10 that of Jupiter, but it has a radius about the same as Jupiter's. WASP-107b's atmosphere is composed primarily of hydrogen and helium. This extended atmosphere is thought to be loosely bound to the planet due to its weak gravity, and scientists suspect it's slowly escaping into space. Observations using the Hubble Space Telescope and other instruments have detected helium in the planet's upper atmosphere, making it one of the first exoplanets where atmospheric escape was detected through helium. WASP-107b is a hot Neptune, as it orbits very close to its star, with a period of just 5.7 days. The proximity to its host star means the planet experiences intense radiation, which likely contributes to its puffy nature and atmospheric loss. Recent studies suggest that WASP-107b may have an unexpectedly small core. This challenges existing models of gas giant formation, which typically require a more massive solid core to attract such large atmospheres. Therefore, this planet may have formed in a different way than other gas giants. Another unusual puffball planet is WASP-15b, located about 900 light-years away in the constellation Centaurus. This planet, classified as a hot Jupiter, has about half the mass of Jupiter while being 40% larger, giving it a density of only about 0.26 grams per cubic centimeter. A year on this planet lasts only 4 Earth days. Due to this close orbit around its star, WASP-15b is extremely hot, with estimated equilibrium temperatures of around 1300 degrees Celsius. One interesting feature of WASP-15b is its unusual orbital alignment. Observations of its transit have shown that it may have a retrograde orbit, meaning it orbits in the opposite direction to the rotation of its host star. This is unexpected, as most planets, including those in our solar system, orbit in the same direction as their star's rotation. This retrograde orbit likely suggests that WASP-15b may have experienced significant gravitational interactions or migration in the past, possibly with other massive objects in its system. There's an intriguing theory that many of the known puffball planets might not be quite as puffy as they appear. Some scientists propose that the low densities observed are misleading, and what we're actually seeing is a result of large ring systems surrounding these planets. To understand this theory, we need to revisit how we discover and measure distant exoplanets. The most common method used is the transit method, where astronomers observe the slight dimming of a star's light when a planet passes in front of it. From this dimming, scientists can estimate the planet's size and density. A larger planet blocks more light, while a smaller one blocks less. It's through this method that astronomers have identified puffball planets. Their size and density measurements, however, don't always seem to add up. These planets are gigantic, but they are far too light for their size. This is where the ring hypothesis comes in. The theory suggests that these planets may have extensive ring systems, much like Saturn's rings, which interfere with our size estimates. When a ringed planet passes in front of its host star, it's not just the planet itself blocking the light, it's the rings as well. The added surface area from the rings causes the planet to seem much larger, leading to miscalculated densities. If you were an alien observing Saturn through a telescope, you might think it was twice as large and far less dense due to its rings. The same effect could be fooling us with these distant puff worlds. While this theory offers a logical explanation for the puffball-like appearance of some exoplanets, it doesn't hold up in every case. Some of these puffball planets orbit so close to their stars that gravitational forces would likely shred any ring systems. In these instances, rings probably aren't the explanation for the planet's low densities. Additionally, even when astronomers adjust hypothetical ring sizes and shapes, they can't always match the precise properties of the transit signals. Currently, our observation techniques aren't precise enough to definitively prove or disprove the existence of rings around these planets. However, the James Webb Space Telescope is providing the resolution and sensitivity needed to investigate these mysterious worlds more closely. With its advanced capabilities, we may soon confirm whether some of these planets are ringed giants masquerading as superpuffs.